Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. Today, a very important topic and a practical as well. We are going to discuss, and the topic is environmental laws. As we all know, for smooth functioning of any community or a district or a state or a country, there must be a certain laws to regulate, to function the systems prevailing in that very particular area. And the certain laws regulate the policies and practices of that country, of that state or the district or the area, as the case may be. Similarly, to regulate the functions or the anthropogenic activities which is being carried out in the world, all over the world, but such anthropogenic activities, be it industrialization, be it manufacturing of products anywhere, be it the transportation sector, be it the commercialized sector, which one way or other way damage the environment, its components, its entities, be it air we breathe, be it water we consume, be it the biological diversity on which the survival of human being depends, in the soil from which the food are obtained. Means any anthropogenic activities which is being carried out in the world is one way or other way affects the environment and its components. No doubt the existence of morality or the moral prevents you to damage any entity of the environment, be it belong to abiotic components like atmospheric component, hydrospheric component or lithospheric component, or the biological components like plant, like animal, like microorganism. But some of the human beings are there which never consider these as interwoven system with ourselves, hence damaging the components of the environment. And to refrain from such damaging and devastating activities, there are certain rules, there are certain regulations, there are certain provisions, there are certain acts which include it. In fact, in the constitution of any constitution of the country. And one more thing to remember here, India is the first ever country which included the environmental provisions or the environmental laws in its constitution in the 42nd amendment in 1976. So what are environmental laws? Environmental laws simply means all those regulations, all those provisions, all those rules and all those acts passed by the parliament from time to time to regulate the activities of human being which is being carried out and is damaging the components of air, be it abiotic or abiotic component. So the constitution of India has number of provisions, and the provisions are the fundamental rights, links to the environment. The directive principles, it also linked with the environment. And the fundamental duties linked with the environment. And the Parliament of India has also passed several acts and laws in order to protect and improve the quality of environment. Now, precisely, environmental laws are rules, regulations, and acts passed by any country from time to time to protect and improve the quality of the environment, be it air, water, soil, biological diversity, or any other component of the environment which is being damaged by the environment from time to time. And such rules and regulations and laws passed by any government from time to time is simply referred as or known as environmental laws. And I repeat, India is the first ever country who provides a slot in its constitution for including the environmental provisions in its constitution. And time to time, India has passed many provisions or the acts, we say, and these are Wildlife Protection Act, Wildlife Protection Act 1972. Number one. Number two. And what are the objectives and functions of passing or implementing or enacting such orders? We shall discuss it later on, one by one. Second thing India passed is Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1981. Similarly, Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974, and one more law which is also known as the Umbrella Act is known as Environment Protection Act 1986. And these are the certain provision or acts which is being passed by Constitution of India from time to time in order to protect and improve the quality of environment, not only for the betterment of the biological diversity of the living organism, but for the betterment of human being as well. So we'll try to discuss superficial objectives of these acts. Wildlife Protection Act means, as the name indicates, objective, the central or the prime objective of passing such act means to protect and improve the quality of the biological diversity and to mitigate the damaging effects on the wildlife, be it microorganism, plants, animals. And the second thing, the Air Pollution Control Act means all the provisions, rules and regulations already framed and mentioned in 1981 to protect and improve the quality of environment. In Air Pollution and Prevention Control Act, you have certain provisions for transportation sector, for industry sector and many more, where you are supposed to regulate, where you are supposed to be abide by the rules and regulations already framed, already laid down. Then the next very act passed, Water Prevention and Control of Pollution. The prime or the main objective of the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act means to maintain and restore the quality of both surface and groundwater. One thing is to maintain, another is to restore. Maintain means to keep the water in such a quality status which is presently in, and restoration means if the water body is already got damaged, then we are supposed to bring back the position of water into its natural state. Then finally, the Environment Protection Act 1986. It includes air, it includes water, it includes soil, includes biological diversity. As we all know, environment includes all biotic and abiotic components. Besides the provisions of these acts, India has also passed many provisions are there in the Indian Constitution which we say a fundamental duties. Fundamental duties. And what is the provision of any article related to the fundamental duties? Part 4 A of Article 51 AG, which states that it becomes the duty of every citizen of India to protect and improve the natural environment, including forest, lakes, rivers, wildlife, and to have compassion for living creatures. Compassion for living creatures means you all know other fundamental duties of the Indian Constitution which imposes on a citizen of India. This is one of the fundamental duty already mentioned in our Indian Constitution, means what you are supposed to do, it becomes your duty to protect and improve the natural environment, be it forest, be it lake, be it rivers, be it wildlife. And what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to have a compassion for living creatures. Means you are not supposed to damage the biological diversities present in our nature. And these are fall under Article 51AG, which is a part 4A of the Indian Constitution. And second thing is a directive principle. Directive principle means you are directed to do anything. Constitution is directing you to maintain certain things, and one thing of the directive principle of the Indian constitution is, means state shall endure. State shall endure means this is the directive principle for any particular state. And what the article 48 says, state shall endure to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forests and wildlife of the country. I shall repeat, state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife of any country. Means states have already been directed to protect the forests, wildlife, and to safeguard the plants, animals, and microorganisms surviving or thriving or existing in their geographical area. And these are the articles, be it a fundamental duty is 51A article, and directive principle are included as per the provisions of Indian Constitution is 42nd amendment in 1976, 42nd amendment. And these provisions are included thereafter the 4 year of the Stockholm conference, which took place in 1972 in Stockholm. And no doubt India is took a great initiative for safeguarding their environment. Hence, it also becomes our duty as a citizen to protect and improve the quality of environment, be it a plant, be it a microorganism, be it an animal, be it the water bodies, be it the air, be it the soil. Hope you understand, and we will discuss the next topics mentioned in your syllabus in the next lectures. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Best of luck.
So then, just hold on.